about vacation photos and how I take it even when I'm not traveling. Maybe you live in a place that doesn't have too much going on. Maybe you live in a smaller town but still want to take great vacation travel photos. I live here in San Francisco, California, probably one of the most beautiful places in the world. I'm sharing with you my top tips on how I take my Instagram photos. Be sure to stick around and watch the entire video to learn how you can win a Polaroid camera just like this. So all you have to do is subscribe to my channel. We are so close to 1 million subscribers. Just click on the button here or down below. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. It totally helps me out. So without further ado, let's jump into this video. Go! I love flowers. It's not a photo shoot with Allie unless you bring fresh flowers with you, whether it's in your hair or in your arms or in your hands. Whenever I take photos outside, I try to find matching colors with my outfit, whether it's in my accessories or shoes or my dress or my top. I just think it makes the outfit composition a lot more pleasing. We're on the hunt for another flower bush and we stumbled across this one. It looks really pretty, but then on the other side, this. I don't know. Hi guys, so I found this bougainvillea bush. I like to kind of like hold the branch in front of my face or like play around with my hat, like hold onto my hat or like hold this hat like to my side, play with my hair, like show off my earrings. I just love fresh flowers. It brings a photo to life. To go to a neighborhood that you typically won't hang out in.
Hey guys, welcome to Chinatown. Today I'm going to show you some of my favorite photography areas and best food here in Chinatown with my friend Allie Eats.
I like going to Chinatown because there's a ton of yummy food and local produce that is usually pretty affordable. We went to one of my favorite childhood dim sum places called Lai Heng Lounge. I hope I pronounced that right. It's been quite a while since I've actually been.
Behind the scenes.
This one doesn't look good.
Which one?
This one.
Sometimes the least pretty things taste the most delicious.
But they have these super cute buns.
So you gotta pour some of the vinegar and soy sauce. We're sitting like 2 inches from this family.
Chinatown might be a very intimidating neighborhood because you might not speak Chinese and there might be a language barrier, but don't worry. I honestly think people are pretty friendly. You could probably find menus with translations and worst case scenario, you just point to what you want. Comment down below and let me know what neighborhood are you from if you're from San Francisco and where is the neighborhood you typically hang out in.
There are a lot of people staring at us wondering what we're doing, but you just gotta go for it.
Ignore the haters.
Ignore the haters. So next stop, we're in this alleyway. It's called Waverly Place in Chinatown. So here you will have all of these lanterns above you.
Some cute buildings.
Yeah, they're all really colorful and bright. Grab your dim sum, her very sad dim sum. She has all the devices.
All the gear right now.
My least favorite thing about traveling is leaving Bella behind. I just never want to leave her, but you know, we gotta do it if we're gonna travel, right? Take a road trip out of your city. So maybe you live in a smaller suburban town. Usually if you drive like an hour or so out of San Francisco, you could find very drastic different scenery. On this day, I decided to go to Santa Cruz with my friend Christina. We ended up making a full trip out of it. We went to this beautiful yellow daisy flower field. Maybe not daisies, more like succulents. went to a really yummy paleo restaurant. They have a lot of healthy food. Been trying to be more healthier for the summertime. One of my biggest pet peeves when it comes to travel photography is if the weather is not good. When I travel and the weather isn't great, it's raining or it's foggy outside, I get a little bit sad because I know that when I'll look back on my photos, I'll remember that it was such a gloomy day. I think it's fine to Photoshop a photo. I use QuickShot on my phone to change the weather sometimes. I know this is a really big extreme and I know not everyone will do it, but I ended up taking a family portrait for Scott's family and I wanted to make sure that it was a nice sunny day. So I went in on my phone, I edited the sky, changed it up to a blue sky, and voila! It's all of a sudden a nice beautiful day and not a gloomy Toronto day.
We're at the Chinatown gates.
She looks like a real tourist.
I know.
Her selfie stick.
I fit in right here.
Here is the final flowers. Oh wow. I think this looks very artistic, Allie, don't you think? I think it looks artistic.
Yeah.
That was my video on how to take travel photos even if you're not traveling outside of your city. So don't forget to subscribe to enter this month's giveaway. I'm giving away this Polaroid camera right here. You can obviously choose whatever color you'd like. Be sure to follow me on Instagram for more style inspiration and photography ideas. I miss you guys so, so much. I've just been renovating my whole house, so it's a complete utter mess. But if you want, be sure to follow me on my vlog channel, Allie's Life. I'll have it linked down below, and I will see you guys next week. Bye!